Australian leaders have welcomed the news of the death, of course. Prime Minister Julia Gillard hopes it's a small measure of justice for those who still grieve the loss of loved ones killed in terrorist attacks. Our political correspondent Matt Moran has just spoken to the Prime Minister in Canberra.
Prime Minister, thanks for your time. Bin Laden might be dead, but the fight against terrorism continues?
Absolutely. The fight against terrorism does continue. The death of bin Laden is a big blow for Al-Qaeda, and that's a good thing. That's a great thing, in fact. But it doesn't mean that Al-Qaeda itself is finished. So the war on terrorism must continue, and our mission in Afghanistan must continue. We're there to try and ensure that Afghanistan never becomes a safe haven for terrorism again, for the training of terrorists, for the planning of terrorist missions, and so our soldiers will continue the fight there.
He was the symbolic head of Al-Qaeda, but did he have control of its operations?
Well, Al-Qaeda is a resilient terrorist network, and consequently it does have more than one leader. It's got many heads, if you like. Osama bin Laden was obviously the face to the world and the leader of Al-Qaeda, the sort of head leader of Al-Qaeda, and so his death is a body blow to Al-Qaeda. But we shouldn't assume that that means Al-Qaeda is finished or that it's got no further capacity to organise terrorist events.
There seems to be some debate about the level of involvement the Pakistan government had, if any. I mean, were they involved in his death?
President Obama yesterday, when he announced the death of Osama bin Laden to the world, thanked the government of Pakistan for its help in leading the United States to Osama bin Laden. So clearly there's been counter-terrorism cooperation between the United States and Pakistan, and we cooperate with Pakistan on counter-terrorism as well, and we'll continue to do so.
Bob Brown believes the death is even more reason to bring our soldiers home from Afghanistan.
Well, I don't agree with that. Our soldiers are there to make sure that Afghanistan doesn't become a safe haven for terrorism again. In order to acquit that mission, we've got to stay the course. We've got to keep training the Afghan National Army and Afghan police. President Karzai of Afghanistan has said he wants local Afghan people to take over security leadership of their country in 2014. So we will be there training and completing our mission.
What's your advice to Australians travelling overseas?
Well, to Australians travelling overseas, we're saying don't get swept up or involved in any mass demonstrations around the world protesting against the death of Osama bin Laden. We haven't seen such protests yet, but it's possible that there will be some. Don't go and have a look or get in the middle of it. That's not a safe place to be. Exercise common sense and vigilance about your personal security. And we always say to people travelling, get on the Department of Foreign Affairs and Trade website and register. That helps us locate Australians if we need to. That comes in handy in all sorts of circumstances. For example, very recently it helped us find Australians in Japan following the earthquake and tsunami. So it's always a smart thing to do.
Is there a risk of homegrown extremists and reprisal attacks in Australia?
Well, we have as a country faced a terrorist risk for a long period of time now. We haven't, as a result of the death of bin Laden, upgraded our local terrorism warnings. But we, of course, continue to show the vigilance that we've always shown and to have our security agencies doing the important work that they need to do everything we can to keep Australians safe.
Thanks for your time, Prime Minister.
Thank you very much.